Fifth graders, begin with Oli Aloha. Fifth graders, please stand. Welcome to the 2023 promotional ceremony for Princess Kailani Elementary School's fifth graders. My name is Avish Arzaga, and I will be your presenter along with King Magat, Maria Ruiz, and Shania Cabusas. Please stand and join us in singing the national anthem, followed by the Hawaii State Anthem.
Like to have the first graders come and present a song we would like to sing for the first graders called We Are a Family.
Love is sweet, love is kind. Love comes from a family of mine.
We're all different people, living together with
would like to have the fourth graders come to the stage and present a hula for the fifth graders. Queen Liliuokalani was the last queen of Hawaii. She was a wonderful role model and was loved and respected by the people of Hawaii.
Queen Liliuokalani became a queen in 1891 when her brother King David Kalakaua passed away. Just 2 years later, the U.S. government took over Hawaii.
Although she was only a queen for a few years, Queen Liliuokalani was known for her wisdom and service to the people of Hawaii.
Queen Liliuokalani was also an amazing songwriter. She composed more than 160 mele or songs during her lifetime.
Many more songs have been written in honor of Queen Liliuokalani, including today's mele inoa.
This hula kahiko expresses the songwriter's loyalty and an aloha for Queen Liliuokalani.
We dedicate today's performance to the fifth grade students. We will miss you.
Together we have navigated this journey through elementary school. To show our gratitude, fifth graders are now excused to present lei.
Coconut tree, so very special to me.
Regardless of how long each of us have been a Kailani student, the combination of our skills and personalities has made the class of 2023 unique. Something we all share is a great respect for our school namesake, Princess Victoria Kailani. To honor her memory, we aim to be self-directed learners, community contributors, complex thinkers, quality producers, effective communicators, and ethical and effective users of technology. And now it is my pleasure to introduce our principal, Mrs. Jill Textor, to say a few words.
Good morning. We at Princess Kaialani Elementary School educate and empower lifelong learners to achieve skills both academically and socially for the changing world. We have worked hard to prepare our students for life, but also for change. Soon, fifth graders, you will be alumni of Kailani Elementary School, and you have much to be proud of. Like Princess Kailani, the love for learning is instilled in our students as well as our teachers. Princess Kailani was fluent in more than one language, and many of you are as well. We understand that this is an asset and embrace the diversity that it brings to our campus. Learning is so much more than just reading, writing, and math. It is our ability to be well-rounded citizens. And through the GLOs, we continue to find success and overcome life's obstacles. In addition to the GLOs that you're very familiar with, I'd also like to add healthy and confident individuals. And this is so fitting because it is the safe practices of social distancing, hand washing, healthy eating, and the confidence to make good, safe, and honest choices that have helped us to continue to survive and thrive despite a worldwide pandemic. May you all find your passion and purpose in life. Give yourself a chance to enjoy everything the world has to offer, so that one day you will also be able to come back and give back to the school and community where your journey began. Congratulations, fifth graders.
Thank you, Mrs. Hepshara. I'd like to ask Maria to come to the stage to share her favorite memories of fifth grade.
There are a lot of memories that I would cherish from this school year. One memory is when Mrs. Wong gave us the afternoon to watch a movie if we did all our work and did well on a test. She even bought us all ice cream. We had fun sitting around and relaxing and laughing from the movie. Another memory is when it was Valentine's Day and Mrs. Wong decorated our classroom. She made a selfie wall with pink, red, and white balloons. She bought us all poster boards and we got to make selfie frames. We took class pictures with our frames and she printed them out to give to us for memories. At the end of the day, we played a Valentine's Pictionary and a Valentine's Day guessing game. She bought different types of containers and all different types of candy. We had to guess on how much candy was in the container. Whoever guessed the closest without going over was the winner. What I miss most about fifth grade is when Mr. Asada would take us out to PE almost every day. We would play volleyball and badminton and laughed a lot. It was fun to get out of the classroom and get some fresh air. I feel towards the end of the school year, some of us got a lot closer as we realized that this would be the last few weeks in being in an elementary school together. Some of us will be going off the island or moving to a different school. All of these memories I will cherish to, I will remember to cherish in elementary school. I'd like to ask Avish to come to the stage to share about her favorite teacher. It's really hard to choose one favorite teacher because in all of my elementary school years, I have two favorite teachers that I cannot pick between. My first favorite teacher is my fourth grade teacher, Miss Chang. I say she's my favorite because she made fourth grade really exciting and thrilling. She never failed to make a day at school really fun, and I always look forward to going to school because of her. She was really sweet and kind most of the time, and she barely ever yelled. She always encouraged my class to do our best, and in my opinion, it always worked. She also taught us about botany, and we got to study the plants that we grew. We also grew some lima bean plants, which we harvested and ate later on. My other favorite teacher is Miss Sago. She is one of my favorite teachers because she wasn't just my teacher, she was also my friend. Other than just teaching our class to other subjects, she also told us stories that gives us life advice that we can use as we continue to grow. She's also one of my favorite teachers because whenever she's not grouchy, she talks to us like we're her friends, not just her students. Another reason why I like her is because she always makes sure that my classmates and I get along, and she always acts right away. She always acts right away when there is a problem between her students instead of dealing with it later. I also like her because when she teaches, she always goes step by step instead of just giving us the answers and always makes sure that everyone understands the lesson at the end before moving on so that everyone is on the same page. If someone doesn't understand the lesson, she explains it again in a more simple way so that they can understand it clearer. Other than that, she also makes us laugh a lot and she always encourages us to try our best. And even if we get some wrong, there is never any judgment made, and this helps us to try harder. Overall, these are my two favorite teachers, and I'd like to thank them for all the wonderful memories, all the lessons that they taught me, and also for the impact they made in my life during my elementary school years. I'd like to ask Shania to come to the stage to share her advice to the fourth graders.
To the current fourth graders who will be in fifth grade next year, here is some advice on how to succeed. One advice I have for you is to focus on your work. Focusing on your work will help you so you don't fall behind. Also, always listen and read carefully. This will help you when taking tests. There may be some tricky questions, but if you read carefully, you will be able to figure out the answer. Another advice I have for you is to show your teacher respect because they work hard and plan field trips or fun activities for you. Your teachers also help you with work as they want you to learn. You need to stay focused on your work and not play around because it will affect your schoolwork and grades. In fifth grade, you will be learning a lot of songs that will be part of your promotion ceremony, so it is important to memorize and lyrics to practice. Finally, you need to be mature because you are the oldest in the school and need to be examples for the other grade. Best of luck next school year.
Thank you, Shania. As we start to look ahead to what middle school brings, we are fortunate to have here today the Vice Principal of Ke'alikolani Middle School. Please give a warm welcome to Vice Principal Hamilton.
Good morning, Princess Ke'alani Elementary School. My name is Vice Principal John Hamilton. I come from the prestigious Princess Ruth Ke'alikolani Middle School, formerly Central Middle School. I'm here today to congratulate all of our fifth graders incoming as sixth graders next school year. It's an honor to be here. This is a beautiful fifth grade promotion ceremony. I want to say mahalo to Principal Teixeira and Vice Principal Jane Toyama for inviting me to be here today. Today is a recognition for fifth graders, all of your hard work, starting in kindergarten to now. You have run the gauntlet of the standards that we've set forth. Learning your numbers, learning your letters, phonics. Now you guys are reading paragraphs, doing algebraic expressions. That hard work that you've done today as fifth graders will continue onward into middle school as well. One of the big things that I challenge you with as incoming sixth graders is that hard work will continue in everything that you do in middle school when you continue your journey. Being on time, prepared for class, being independent, self-directed learners is essential for your success, not only in middle school, but in high school and in life. We have a lot of fun things in middle school that we want to welcome you with. We have our attendance arcade. We have esports. We have our orchestra and band performances. All of these great experiences await you. But at the same time, as middle schoolers, we're gonna hold you to high expectations as well to be those independent, lifelong learners. As your future vice principal, my first act is I'm gonna give you guys homework. I'm sorry. Homework assignment today. I want you to find the adult on campus that you've connected with the most over these past 6 years. And I want you to look them in the eye, and I want you to thank them for all the love that they've poured into you, all the support that they've given you over the years. That's your first assignment. Second assignment, tonight, when you eat dinner with your parents, I want you to look into their eyes as well. And I want you to thank them for all the love and support that they've given you since you've come into this world. Without them, you would not be here today. And it's gonna be that same support that's gonna carry you through not only your middle school career, but your high school career and beyond. Thank you so much for having me here today. Congratulations, fifth graders. Mahalo.
I will now read the names of students who earned a Strive High Award. Please stand where your name is called, and please hold your applause until all names are called. Hi. Mike Chi Chen, Audrina Creta Medina, Kaylin Amir Crustis, Catherine Claire Dagdagan, Rebecca Filamoni, Janaea Leigh Nunebo, Jennifer Pang, Philip Johan Sipno, Via Grace Suyat. I will now read names of students who earned a Scholar Award. Awardees are students who received all Emmys in math, science, reading, writing, and social studies. Please stand where your name is called. Christopher J. Carrera, Jordan Abatayo, King Magat, Stephen Villasenor, Avish Abazaga. Please give these hardworking students a round of applause.
I'd like to introduce Mrs. Okinaka and Mr. Kawai, who would like to recognize the JPLs.
Good morning. My name is Mrs. Okinaka, and this is Mr. Kawai. And we are the JPO advisors. It is our pleasure to present the fifth grade students, JPO students, with their certificates for outstanding duty to keep our students safe and showing citizenship and community responsibility. When your name is called, please come forward. Jonathan Langren. Saint Sanarivi. And Charlotte Tui.
And for being JPOs for the past 2 years, Maria Ruiz and Javion Villadis. and one of these JPLs has been chosen to be JPL of the Year by the Honolulu Police Department and the Department of Transportation. And that JPL is Javian Pilatos. For your service and much luck to you in the future.
I would like to invite Mrs. Texture and Mrs. Toyama to present our promotional certificates and peacock feathers.
Charlotte Tui. Jeremiah Peru. Marianta Agan. Solomon Lafaele. Javian Villados. Mai Chi Chen. James Nepal. Vicky Bukwag. Daniel Ludwig. Saint Sonarini. Richard Ricat. Matinson Matone. Benson Nguyen. Tylin Liu. K.R. Albert. Simon Preston.
David Chosa. Christopher J. Carrera. Fifana and Fish. Maria de Jesus Ruiz. Anthony Epero. Shania Cabosas. Chieko Komusen. Anderson Rain. Aichun Hans. Philip Johan Siapno. Avish Arzada. Adrina Credo Medina. Dandalvan. Yuha Ron. Kaylin Amira Cuestas. Mitchelton Robert. Rebecca Filamoni.
Jennifer Pang. Janaya Le Nivola. King Magot. Thank you.
Tyrone Jeff Collingwood.
We'd like to recognize students who were not able to attend today's ceremony, Saidal Uturang and Aiden Tafal Puahi.
Family and friends, I would like to present to you Ka'ialani Elementary's Class of 2023.
The fifth graders will now present their graduation song called You Raise Me Up. The lyrics represent the feeling we have for all who played a part in helping us get to this day. Here is You Raise Me Up from the Class of 2023.
Thank you.
to conclude our 2023 promotional ceremony, and as a final tribute to each other, we'd ask you to stand and join us in singing the alma mater for the last time as elementary students.
Once again, congratulations to the class of 2023.
Thank you everyone for joining us in this celebration. This concludes our ceremonies.